Hi, my name is David Stitt, and I am with the Stitt Group in Rogers, Arkansas. Wanted to continue our conversation about passive solar design. I'm inside this home now, and I'm taking a video of the thermostat. Two numbers of importance there are on the right side, you'll see 72, that is the thermostat setting, the heat to number, and then 80 degrees is the indoor air temperature. So it's very nice that on a very cold winter day, somewhere in the high 20s or low 30s in January, that our indoor air temperature is much higher than the thermostat setting. This happens as a result of good design and planning. You'll see lots of glass in this house, most of which is facing south. The sun at this time of the year is low in the sky, therefore the sun can come below the overhangs, through the glass, provide heat and light to the occupants. In addition, in the corner here, there's a wood stove that can provide supplemental heat on cloudy days or at night. Now, passive solar design concepts not only work well in the wintertime, but they work very well in the summertime as well. In the summer, the sun is very high in the sky, and we calculate overhangs so that the overhangs will shade those windows all summer, keeping the house cool. I often am asked about people that have purchased a piece of property and they say, I want to do this, but I don't have a good south view or south orientation. Well, we have a saying here in our company that says, houses have four sides, at least four sides, therefore they face four directions. So you may not have the perfect south orientation, but you likely have a portion of your house that could utilize passive solar design, providing summertime cooling and wintertime heating. For more information, you can go to our website, www.thestittgroup.com.